In this video, we will provide an overview of engineering stress-strain diagrams for metals. Engineering stress-strain diagrams are developed from physical testing. A carefully prepared test specimen is subjected to a tensile test in a universal testing machine. The testing procedure is typically guided by a standard, such as ASTM, American Society for Testing and Materials. This ensures that everyone who is performing the test follows the same procedure. Stress-strain diagrams allow us to plot the results from tensile tests and graphically identify important mechanical properties. As a reminder, stress is force per unit area that results from an applied load. Now, these applied loads could be in tension, compression, shear, torsion, or any combination. Strain is the physical deformation response of a material to stress. So an example of strain would be elongation of a material. When a test specimen is first placed in a tension testing machine, the force is increased and the strain is proportionally increased. If we look on our stress strain diagram, this is the linear portion of our graph. If you were to release the specimen in this region, the specimen would return to its original shape, so no deformation has taken place. If we think about the specimen at the micro level, the bonds are stretching. This is considered the elastic region of the stress strain diagram. The slope of the line in the elastic region is the modulus of elasticity, also known as the material stiffness. As we increase the load being applied to the test specimen, we will reach a point where there is no longer linear behavior. This is our proportional limit. With a little more loading past our proportional limit, we will have noticeable permanent deformation that takes place in our test specimen. This point is our yield stress. Yield stress is the stress associated with this point. Yield stress starts at 0.2% strain for most metals. What this means is, if we stop our tensile test and unload the specimen, we find the engineering strain is 0.002. Note, since there is a degree of elastic recovery, we do not draw the unload line straight down. We draw it parallel to the elastic curve. One thing to also realize is at a microscopic level, we have dislocation motion and permanent deformation that has occurred. That is why we are now in what we would call our plastic region. With additional force, the test specimen will eventually begin to neck. Or rather, the diameter or thickness of the test specimen decreases in size. We call this point the ultimate tensile strength, or UTS. This is the maximum possible engineering stress that the specimen can take in tension. If we continue to load our specimen with additional force, we will find that the specimen will eventually fail. At this point, our bonds have completely broken. As we did with the yield stress, if we want to understand the engineering strain at fracture, we need to unload parallel to our modulus of elasticity line. For designers, modulus of elasticity, yield strength, and ultimate tensile strength are all important mechanical properties. We need to make sure we're designing components as well as products that can withstand the strength of the materials that are being used within the product. We need to make sure our components as well as our products do not go beyond the yield strength or ultimate tensile strength when they're in service, or failure will end up occurring. These are some of the elements that design engineers need to take into account from mechanical properties.